Welcome back to Growing Graph, friends. This side Sonia here, and today I have this beautiful project and I'm so happy that it really turned out well. I was super excited to make this one. So here is the Pringle jar, and I altered this with some beautiful decoupage paper and some accessories. So this is the jar which I had, and I have few more, and I just thought why not to alter this. So, and I have this beautiful decoupage paper, and I loved each and every design of this pack, and that's the reason I was really confused on which one to use. So either maybe I'll just put it on the box and I'll see that which one is looking better. And this was a really tough task, really confusing one, but I'm happy I could finalize the second design paper which I have picked up, and this looks absolutely gorgeous in this box. Now I've already cut the paper to the size of my jar, and now with my Mod Podge I'm going to stick it on my jar. And yes, I'm going to apply a generous amount of Mod Podge. First I'm going to apply Mod Podge on my complete jar, and then at the end I'm going to seal it with some little more Mod Podge at the end of the paper so that it sticks really well, cause it should not come out. This is something which is going to hold and have the proper design on my jar. Now this is really a fun technique. Like with the decoupage papers, you can decorate and alter anything and everything at your home and your offices, and they are going to look fab. It's just that you need to decide on the correct paper, the correct size, and you need to also have the matching or something related to the embellishment so that your works looks really pretty. So here my bottle is done and it looks super nice, and now it's time to add some chalk paint. So here the jar's top and the bottom area has some fine thin lines, the border thing, so I'm going to just highlight that and do a little bit of chalk paint on my edges of my bottle. This is just to bring a little more symmetrical to my bottle, and here I'm going to use my chalk paint for this, and that's it. That's the only coloring part which I'm going to do in this project. Selecting embellishments is at times a task, cause when you have such amazing and beautiful decoupage papers and when you have options to add so many colors to it, it becomes really confusing. So here I have already selected the embellishments and I'm going to stick them with my glue gun. And as you can see that I am not applying glue gun on the complete areas, cause this is a decorative piece and it is not going to come out. My glue gun is going to work really well here. So here I'm starting all the ribbon sticking work from one end, from the center part, so that all the joints come at the back side of my jar, and it looks really neat when you are keeping it on a center table or the corner table, and you will not see the stitches at all. So here I have taken a red color ribbon, green color ribbon, and I was really confused whether to go with this golden one or not, but I really absolutely love this one, and this is actually going to be a very decorative piece for my home. And as the festivals are coming, they are just going to add some more drama, some more colors and some more nice decor to your place. Now once I'm done with my ribbon work, I'm just going to cut the extra pieces, and now it's time to stick my embellishments. So here I have few of the dry arrangements and I'm going to stick that really well on my project, again with the glue gun only. When I'm working with decoupage papers, I tend to use more of embellishments, cause embellishments look so fab with decoupage papers, and With napkins, you play around with the colors, the chalk paints, and it works well. So this is again my personal thought, and that is how I love doing that. So with this, my project is done, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any feedback, please do comment below. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you guys. And yes, I have listed all the supplies down in the description box with all the links to buy them in USA and India. And I hope to bring up some more video tutorials really, really soon. And please, please, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Thank you. Bye-bye.